Hello, I am Araceli Soto from Second Life and Trendy and Coffee from Blogspot and Flickr, and today I'll give you 10 simple and useful tips to try on and use in Photoshop. The most important thing is that you don't need a Wacom to use these tips. First of all, this is not a professional video, these are just simple tips. This is a hobby for me, and I just feel the necessity of being helpful for some of you. And secondly, English is not my mother tongue, as you can hear, it's Spanish, so you're going to find many spelling mistakes during the whole video. So sorry for that, I'm just trying my best. When taking photographies in Second Life, it's all about graphics, the size of the picture. I'm going to put here the size I use, but you can take from this size higher. The wind light is very important. For me, it's the most important thing when taking photographies, and the angle you are using. So when talking about size, you can use the one that appears here or higher. That would be great. For wind light, in my opinion, you had to play with them in order to find the perfect one for your picture, to create good shadows and lighting. And about the angle, I recommend to press the Alt button in the keyboard and left click on your AVI and just try to find the perfect angle for the photography you want to take. You can also play with the control button of the keyboard and pressing 0 or 9, and you zoom in and zoom out to your AVI. I use this tool to give shadowing or lightning in some parts of the skin. The tool is this one, and the size depends on the picture. The range has to be in mid-tones. Exposure in 23%, or that's what I recommend, and you have to protect tones. So with this tool, you give shadowing in obscure parts of the skin and you make brighter the bright parts of the skin. You have to look for the size first. This is the perfect size, I mean, for the face. And then, to make a bright part, just click on the bright parts. Just click there. If you want to give shadowing, you have to press the Alt button in the keyboard. For example, here, I'm pressing Alt and doing it with the mouse. Same here. You just have to play with it. There, I'm pressing Alt. Then I'm not, because I want to be lightning. And then I want to give shadowing, so I press Alt again. And this is with the whole picture. Like this. You can do a bigger size. This is something that my friend Len Kaos recommended me once, and it's the color lookup. You have to go to Image, Adjustments, and Color Lookup. And in the first one, you have to play with all of them. What they do is to change the color of the whole picture. With and without. This is something I use to give a special kind of lighting to the picture. You have to go to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects. And then here you have to play with this. In the center there is a light. Okay, you can change the size of it. I'm going to leave it like this. And you put the light where you want. You can move it. And here you have to play with this. This is the color of the light. I always use them in whites or in a warmer color. The intensity, this is too much. I will use it there. This is the size, okay, of the light. Color, general color, gloss, metallic, and this is the shadow. There we go. Okay. This is something that will help you a lot if you don't have a Wacom. To make your hair look better, first you need to use this tool to select the hair. Okay. Something more or less like this. You have to go to filter and oil paint, and you have to play with this. That's all. This is something that I really love using, and it's particles. I have these ones, for example. In this picture I'm going to use this one. You have to copy it and paste it in the picture. Then, to make it bigger. And here, you have to select screen, and it's going to be something like this. In opacity, you can put it the opacity you want. You're going to use in 60%. That's all. To create your own lightning, you have to create a new layer. And to put it in soft light. Then you have to choose a big brush, something like this, smaller, and a color. And then you just play with it where you want to give light. Many colors. Now I'm going to tell you how to make your eyes look more natural when closed. First, you have to create a new layer, this brush, and this size, more or less. Then you have to press the Alt button in the keyboard and to select this tone that the skin has here. Then we have to paint all the eye. Like this. I'm just going to do the half of the face so you see the difference. Then you had to go to filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. And then you erase all these parts. And there we go. Then we had to create another layer to give a little lightning here, where the eye is. You have to choose a smaller brush, and the color has to be white. And then you have to make a little triangle there. You have to go to filter again, blur, Gaussian blur. Something like that. And then again we erase this part. In opacity, we lower it there, and then layer and flatten image. There we go. Finally, to make the eye look better, we have to use the first tool I told you, this one. Okay, and I will tell you. I'm pressing Alt and the mouse. Not pressing. And pressing. Not pressing. Not pressing. And pressing. There you go, you have to play with it. And finally, I'm going to give you the final tip for the eyes too, to make them look better. You have to look for a smaller size of the brush. Let's make it closer, but not that much. And in white. Just do something like this, the eye. Okay. And then you lower the opacity. And there it is. The eye is looking much better, brighter. Thank you so much for watching. I'm really sorry for my English, and I'm really sorry for my voice. It's 6 a.m. on here and I'm really tired, but I really hope you can find this video useful. And if you use any of these tips in any edit, I will be very glad if you show me. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in Facebook or leave in a comment here below. If you have any idea, you can also tell me here in the comments. Thank you so much for your support, and I will leave some links and details here below the video. Thank you so much again. Bye bye.